What's up guys, Delonte here. Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be talking about these Sony WH-1000XM4s shortened to XM4s for the rest of this review. Now, this particular set of headphones could be purchased for $350, currently on sale for $274.95, which places them in the premium section of Bluetooth wireless headphones. Now, I've been rocking these Sony XM4s since September of 2020, and they've been a really good, reliable set of headphones. Can that be said for 2021? Or better yet, the question would be, could I recommend a purchase in 2021? Now, at the end of this video, you will get a chance to hear exactly how they sound, so please have a good set of headphones ready for easy listening. If you're into content like this, make sure you hit the subscribe button below. But with that being said, let's get straight into it. The Sony XM4s have a lot in common with the XM3s. They have the same touch controls, same 30-hour battery life, to include the 10-minute quick charge for 5 additional hours of battery life, same overall look, etc. As a matter of fact, the only way to tell the difference between the two externally is the fact that the XM4s have a more matte feel. It also has a darker NFC badge and the little logo on the XM4s to let you know that you do in fact have the XM4s. Other than that, it would be really hard to tell the difference between the two. The Sony XM4s weigh 8.95 ounces, and as far as a stress test, the headphones actually feel pretty good and shouldn't give you any issues. The headphones are made from a plastic material, and the clamping force is minimal, almost non-existent, just like the Sony XM3s. But they have added extra cushion in the ear cup and the headband to the XM4. The ear cups are pretty wide, and with the added cushion, you shouldn't experience ear cramp or fatigue. Now, there's also a very satisfying click, perfect for when you want to set the headphones down and place them right back on your head where they were without much thought. As I said earlier, the same gestures from the Sony XM3s on the right cup: swipe up for volume up, swipe down for volume down, swipe back to repeat track or previous track, and swipe forward to skip to the next track. Double tap to play and pause a track or answer and hang up a call. You also have the USB-C charging port conveniently located at the bottom. On the left cup, tap the power button and that will let you know how much battery is remaining. Hold the power button and it turns the headphones on and off. There's a custom button that was renamed from NC Ambient on the Sony XM3s. It toggles the Google Assistant and Alexa or toggles your noise canceling on and off. You also have non-proprietary 3.5 to 3.5 millimeter headphone jack cables that came with the headphones. Then you take a look at the internal differences, and it's the little things that make these headphones shine. First, they updated the headphones to Bluetooth 5.0. Now, there were two major downfalls for the Sony XM3s. One was the ability to connect to two different devices, and then the other was call quality. Now, I am happy to say that the Sony XM4s have addressed the ability to connect to two different devices. Simply open the app, connect one device, and connect a second device, and just like that, you can now switch between devices. Call quality has been addressed as well. I used to get a lot of people saying that they couldn't hear me, especially when I was outside. Now people are saying that they hear me just fine. As a matter of fact, these headphones do a really good job at canceling the noise around you on a call. Now, don't get me wrong, the Bose NC700 and Apple's AirPods Max are still the cream of the crop when it comes to call quality, but Sony's XM4s would definitely get the job done. The battery life, as I mentioned earlier, is advertised at 30 hours. Now, I've had no issues whatsoever with battery life. The battery generally lasts me about a week or two in some cases. Now, this will vary depending on how loud you play your music and how often you actually use your headphones, but I've had zero issues so far with battery, especially when you can do a 10-minute quick charge and get 5 hours of playback time. The battery has been pretty solid. The real reason you buy a set of headphones is for the sound, right? Now, I can definitely tell you that the Sony XM4s do not disappoint in this section. Sony uses something that they call DSEE Extreme, and what that does is rebuild audio that was lost during compression. The XM4s utilizes 40mm drivers that sound really good. Deep lows, crisp highs, and really nice mids that gives you a very satisfying listening experience. You will get a chance to hear that later on in this video to make your own decision. Also, if you are using a music streaming service like Tidal, you now have the ability to really use the headphones using LDAC. See, LDAC is Sony's proprietary Bluetooth codec that supports a bitrate of 990 kilobits per second. Now, this can only be used on an Android device at the time of making this video. iOS devices use AAC. Now, Apple has announced its own high-end listening codec called ALAC, but that will be discussed in another video. The noise cancellation has been improved. Sony placed a lot of marketing around the noise canceling, and it actually does a really good job. See, the Sony XM3s and the Bose NC700s were really good at canceling noise like airplane noise, train noise, and things like that. The Sony XM4s stepped the game up for better cancellation of things like people talking or babies crying. See, I had a neighbor that had an infant, and that little guy would literally scream all day. Thank God I had the Sony XM4s around, because the Sony XM3s and the Bose NC700 just wasn't quite up to speed for that particular situation. The XM4s have a feature called Speak to Chat. The gist of it stops the music when you talk, allowing you to have a conversation without having to take the headphones off or any other physical movement. Now, it's a really nice feature depending on what it is you are doing while using it. The transparency mode is really good as well. Tap on the custom button to go from noise canceling to transparency, and this is what you get.
This is a test of the Sony WH-1000XM4s, noise canceling and transparency mode off.
This is a test of the Sony WH-1000XM4s, transparency mode. What do you guys think?
Sony has included a sensor that will recognize when you take your headphones off and stop the music for you. Now, this has been great because although you can talk to people with the headphones on, it still seems kind of weird, and you may get looked at some type of way for not giving someone your undivided attention while conversing. Speaking of which, quick attention is still here, which has come in handy quite a few times. Place your right hand over the right ear cup and it will automatically lower the volume and allow you to hear the person if you need to answer a question in a pinch. There's a very satisfying audible sound you get now when you start and stop the music. That same sound lets you know when you successfully hung up a call when you tap to end the call. It's the little things that help make these headphones a lot better. Also, the highs seem to have been elevated. Now, Sony doesn't quite say this anywhere on their website or anything like that, but to me, it sounds like it's a lot more clearer or crisper. Now, that might not be the best way to describe it, but it definitely sounds better. Lastly, if you like the Sony app, you'll definitely love the Sony app now. It's pretty much the same app, but tweaked a bit for the XM4s. You'll see things like the multi-pairing section, the speak to chat section. You still have the equalizer there, which is good because it allows you to modify your music to the way you like it. It's pretty much the same app, but it's just tweaked a bit for more options with the XM4s. Now for the cons. Sony has given us the option to pair two devices, but it generally takes a while for that second device to actually pair. The LDAC codec that we discussed earlier is only available if you do not pair a second device. Now, if you're an iOS user, that doesn't really matter because AAC is the primary Bluetooth codec anyway, but if you're an Android user and you're fully capable of using LDAC, you would need to decide whether you want to use LDAC or pair to a second device. Also, the Sony XM4s only support LDAC, AAC, and SBC Bluetooth codecs. The speak to chat feature that we discussed earlier, if you are the type of person that likes to sing along with your music, go ahead and do yourself a favor and turn that off. It will stop so many times and it will be more annoying than satisfying. Luckily, you can easily turn it off with two fingers to the right ear cup. but just be aware that it will turn the music off if it hears anything speaking in its vicinity. Now, with all that being said, let's see how the Sony XM4's call quality and noise canceling work in the real world.
All right, guys, so this is the Sony WH-1000XM4's call quality. Once again, Sony WH-1000XM4 call quality with a highway below us. What do you guys think?
Noise canceling.
So what do you guys think? I personally think the Sony XM4s do a pretty good job in the phone call department. Now, the Bose NC700s and Apple's AirPods Max, as I said earlier, are the cream of the crop in regards to call quality, but the Sony XM4s would definitely get the job done. As far as noise canceling, I think the Sony XM4s do a really good, outstanding job and the noise canceling department. All right, so the next section will be to allow you to hear the music as I hear it here using my binaural microphones. This is where you will need your headphones. Let me know in the comments below what you guys think. Here we go. So, could I still recommend the Sony XM4s in 2021, especially at the price of $350? Well, that actually kind of depends on what it is you are looking for. See, the headphones are generally on sale, so you really shouldn't have a problem finding them lower than list price, especially since they've been out since August of 2020. Now, I will also say that if you have the XM3s, the XM4s aren't necessarily a must-have item, especially since you get about 80% of the XM4s with really good sound. But I will also say, if you're like me and were tired of changing or connecting from one device to go to the next device and then disconnecting that device to go back to the previous device, or if you make a lot of phone calls with your headphones, then the Sony XM4s could be a good purchase for you. The Sony XM4s are a full-featured pair of headphones that are fully customizable and feel great. I can definitely recommend them in 2021, especially since they're generally on sale. Now, that's all I have for this particular video, but what do you guys think? Did I miss something? Something you want to add? Leave a comment below. Like the video if you liked the video. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit the notification bell so you know when the next video is posted, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Thanks for watching.